This is a sad song. It's a story about a transvestite that wants to become Miss America. He must become Miss America, no matter what the consequences. You've got to kill Miss America.
Thank you.
This is our first CD. We've never played it out live before, at least around here. This song is called Goddamn I Am.
Same deal, same deal. something like this.
Kick his ass!
Oh. I wanna be a man!
Thank you.
you've all been waiting for. Ladies and gentlemen, I'd like to bring out to the stage the Confederate Crusader. Yeah.
Frankenstein.
Got a little surprise for you tonight, ladies and gentlemen. Please, would you welcome Sick of Zero?
You fucking bastards, I hear you calling, but I can't come home right now. Cause me and the fucking girls are playing, and we wanna get out of this goddamn town. Just a few more minutes, and we'll be right home to you. Hey girls, I hear them calling. What the fuck you gonna do? Well, we're fucking rocking on your ass, fucking sorry bastards. This ain't no goddamn alternative shit either, fucking pussies.
There's only one thing you can say after that. What the fuck about that bamboo
You gotta help me out here. I went in my son's room, and I found a CD of a band, and it just really, really offended me, really, really bad. The cover of the artwork on it, and I just didn't know what to do. I don't really want to talk about it there. It's pretty offensive, but it depicted a picture of a man on a cross, and he was in drag. Like a drag queen, and it said cross dress. And I was just totally offended, and I went to my son and I said, "What is this garbage?" And he just started screaming at me. Like I was in the wrong to yell at him. I just don't know what to do.
Well, I tell you what, something that's very important. Kids, they tend to not to look at this artwork because it's a band. They have a tendency to put these people up on a pedestal and they can do no wrong. I think what you need to do, you would be, if you probably read the lyrics that's on the music, you'd probably be more offended by the lyrics than you would the artwork.
Oh, it's awful lyrics, awful.
Right. Well, see, what happens is they don't hear the music because they can't understand it. They hear that beat and they hear that thrashing of the music, and that's where the demonic type lyrics come into effect.
It's very demonic.
Right, and they don't hear that because of the music. What you're gonna have to do, and I know I've had to do this to my own son. My son is 10 years old, but what we did was we just went through all of his lyrics. Now, he's not into that heavy rock and roll, heavy metal, but that rap stuff, you know?
Oh, yeah, that's bad.
And the lyrics in it is mostly about sex, one way or the other, but, you know, we just sort of try to to just take these things away from him and try to be more, in control of the situation. Now, if he's a little bit older, he's probably going to give you a little bit more of a fight than a 10-year-old would, but they put up a good fight, too.
But he's 12.
What you're going to have to do probably is just sit down. Are you involved in church?
I used to be. I still believe in the Lord and everything. I try to, teach my son the same thing, but the thing is he says he's friends with these guys. They're local or something. I don't know. Something Frankenstein drag queens.
Right. Can you tell me the name of the band?
They're called the Frankenstein drag queens.
Right.
From something I don't know.
Yeah, they're probably a local band. We've heard about a couple of those bands that around here are doing some real wild stuff. But I tell you, the best thing you can do is not to, in my own experience, demand that he stay away from this, but just show him in a way, through your religious beliefs.
Yes.
To say, look, this is not right. What you might could do is not, you say, look, I'm not going to allow you to listen to this in my house, but the first thing he's going to do when he gets in the car or gets away from you is he's going to turn this radio on and listen to that.
Right.
But what you need to do is just try to keep your communication line opened up to him and just, say, listen, hey, if you want to listen to that, you got to listen to it around me and sit there and, hey, get there with him and just say, hey, if you're going to listen to that, I'm going to be right there with you.
Yeah.
And just say,
what can we do about these bands?
There's nothing you can do about it because...
I'm going to give them a good whipping.
Now, that's true. Well, we there's a lot of things we'd like to do, but that's not going to do it. The best thing you can do is just try... See, what happens is when they're purchasing this stuff, it's just adding fuel to the fire, and
they mail it to him. I don't know how they got the address. I guess he's sent it in to them.
That's true. Well, they probably get it. We get stuff... Sometimes you get stuff mailed to you because you're on a mailing list because you don't even know you're on the mailing list. You get credit cards and stuff like that, too.
Yeah.
If you go to a shop, let's say, that sells rock and roll type material, and they just fill out a little questionnaire, they're going to get all the trash that comes out the first time it comes out because that's the way they do. They give everybody a little taste of this stuff, and then it gets, just like Tommy said, it gets in your system.
Yeah.
And then from the stuff you see, that artwork, then it becomes tattoos all over their body.
He's already got a tattoo. And the thing that really concerns me about it all is that this band is sort of racial. I mean, see, I am in an interracial marriage. My wife's a black.
Uh-huh.
And everything. This band depicts T-shirts that are just, very offensive to black. It says, make them slaves again.
Right.
And it says the word nigger.
Right. Well, that's going to... Well, you're going to find that all the time. That's going to happen. But what you're going to have to do is, I think the best thing you can do is probably not forbid him to to stay away from this, but you're going to have to give him an angle where you say, listen, you're going to have to get some type of communication open up with him where, the worst thing you could do is forbid him to do it. I really believe that because it's going to happen. And you're just going to have to pray for him, and you're going to have to get together, and all your family's going to have to get together and talk about it. How old is your son?
Huh?
How old is he?
He's 12.
He's 12?
Wow.
Okay, well, if he's that old, then I believe you can just take that stuff away from him and,
He's pretty big.
He's what?
He's pretty big.
Well, that's all. Go ahead, caller.
Hello?
Yeah, go ahead.
Oh, hi. The gentleman that called earlier about his son with the band, the CD that he found. I know the band that he's speaking of. I wanted to comment on that. I saw this band around Christmas time, and a friend of mine took me to a club in Charlotte and told me that a Christian band called Striper was going to be playing there, a Christian contemporary band. And apparently it's just a really big joke that, that I really didn't appreciate. They did, as he mentioned, the sacrilegious art on the front of the CD. Well, there's a couple other things that they did that really bothered me, and there's some things, you guys said that there's not a lot that can be done, but, boycotts of clubs like this can be done, things like that. Let me just give you an idea of what happened. It was around Christmas time, like I said, and the nativity scenes that you can find on lawns and things like that? You guys know what I'm talking about?
I can't hardly understand you. You're talking a little bit too fast.
Oh, I'm sorry. Okay, the nativity scenes that you can find on front lawns things like that.
Nativity scenes, yeah.
Right, yeah. Well, they had one of these on the stage, and these guys did some extremely awful things to Joseph. I mean, it was ridiculous.
What you're saying is you attended a concert by these guys?
Yes, I did. It was quite possibly the most ridiculous thing I've ever seen in my life.
Right.
Definitely the most offensive. And things like this have to be, things like this really need to be done to stop these bands. I mean, they're really spreading some really demonic, some really sacrilegious messages that are really infecting the minds of young people these days.
Well, see, that's the joke of it. See, that's why our government is a joke, because this is freedom of their expression. You know, that is a joke. What it is they're talking about Jesus. They're just degrading the birth of Christ there and making something satanic out of it. But the thing about it is, to see that kind of trash on an album cover and then go attend that concert and see that firsthand, you ought to know that's not right. You know what I'm saying?
Thing. One other thing I just want to mention, just so you guys can just get one more feel of what these guys really do. They took probably one of the biggest Bibles I've ever seen in my life, and the lead singer licked it on stage in a very grotesque manner. You see, I'm not sure exactly what needs to be done, whether it be boycotts or anything like that. Boycotts of the clubs or the products that they put out, such as T-shirts, the companies that back them. I'm not sure what, but, between the four of us and the rest of the Christians in the country, we can do something if we make our voices heard.
Well, that's true. That's just like in the paper the other day, you seen on the news, they arrest people for having homosexual relationships in the park with each other, but they let them do it on the stage at the downtown Charlotte theater.
Yeah.
Now, that's a joke right there. But you're right. What needs to be done is that instead of three people standing up here and saying we're tired of it, is we're going to have to stand together and do it. And you can make more of a voice together than you can one man at a time. What we need is more people to take a stand,
right.
And you're exactly right. We appreciate you calling.
Go ahead.
She's upset. It's okay. Hon, I tell you what, if we've got your phone number, we'll be more than glad to call you back in just a few minutes.
Excuse me?
Does our counselors have your phone number?
Can we call you back?
It's not that. It's just it's really upsetting me hearing about these bands and stuff.
Right. Well, hon, we can understand that. We're on the air for a few minutes. If you'd like for us to call you once we're off the air.
It's too late.
Well, okay. Do you need us to, is there anything we could do for you now? Or?
Well, I'm just wanting to ask you a question about it all. Excuse me? Am I still on the air?
Yes.
Oh, okay, I couldn't hear myself. It's just that, I mean, I have a daughter and she listens to that kind of music and I'm afraid she's going to get a hold of it. And if I find her with it, I might tan her hide. And I don't really want to do that because I don't want to... My dad used to hit me.
Right. How old is your daughter?
She's 8.
8?
Yes.
She's 8 years old?
Yes.
And she's listening to this kind of music at that age?
Well, I try to be really open-minded with her. I mean, I don't really know how to explain it. She calls it zombie rock.
Uh-huh.
But, I just don't know what to do about it. I mean, I'm afraid she might get a hold of this stuff, and then she might turn into a demonic.
Yeah, I understand what you're saying. Well, that kind of music, I tell you what, you can tell from the type of dress that these people dress on. They're gonna dress, they're going to act, they're going to be just like these people because they look up to them because they see nothing wrong with it.
Just like Satan.
Yeah, that's
right.
What you're going to have
that's
to do.
Is,
sure. Yeah, you're going to have to take some type of control over her, and you're just going to have to just lay the law down and take this away from her. But, you know, what you're going to have to do, and I think this is very important, is you can't forbid these kids to do this. You can, but what it's going to do is just going to force them to want it more and more.
Yeah.
So what you're going to have to do it in a loving way and just show your concern, not that you hate that type of thing, which I know you do, But if you can do it in a loving way, that's the main thing.
Oh. I think
that music. I just think all that kind of music just. It needs to be done away
with. That's right. I'm in the same position, too, with an 8-year-old son like that. I don't get a chance. We've done a segment before where he lives in another state with my ex-wife that I have or whatever. I have no control as a father right now to actually know what he is listening to. He's 8 years old. And it tears me apart as a father, of a child also, to wonder what he's listening to. And I don't even have an effect in the home of him. So like Jeff and those were saying, share yourself to it, and just hopefully, you just have to be the parent figure, but at the same time, too, strong, but just show them that genuine concern as a parent.
All right, Tommy, thanks for being with us, man.
Rubber! Rubber, Pappy! Rubber! Rubber!
Yeah! Uncle Goddamn!
Uncle Goddamn!